students, welcome back to the next module of our chapter called Electrostatics. Now students, in the previous two modules, we have already covered the concept of insertion of dielectrics in capacitors. Now students, in this particular module, we'll be learning multiple choice questions which are based on the same concept, right? So let us start. Now first question, it says a parallel plate capacitor with oil as a dielectric between the plates has capacitance C. If the oil with dielectric constant K equal to 3 is removed, then the capacity of the capacitor will be option A is 3C, option B is C by root 3, option C is C by 3, and last option is root C into 3. Now students, in this particular case, we are provided with capacitor which is having oil present between the two plates, and we are supposed to find out the capacity once that oil is removed, right? So let us start with the solution. Let us analyze this carefully. We are provided with a parallel plate capacitor with oil as dielectric between the plates of capacitor, and that capacitor is having capacity capital C. Now students, as oil is present between the two plates, I can say medium is present, right? And as medium is present, so I can say this is the capacitor which is having medium present, so I can say C medium, it is equal to capital C, right? Now students, as oil is present, this particular oil is having dielectric constant K equal to 3, right? So I can also write K equal to 3, and this oil is removed from that particular capacitor. Now students, as oil is removed, that means I can say medium is removed. As medium is removed, what will be left? Air will be left between the two plates of capacitor, and we are supposed to find the capacity of that capacitor once oil is removed, or I mean to say, we are supposed to find capacity of capacitor with air present between the two plates, right? So that means we'll find out C air. So students, here we are provided with C medium, we are provided with K, and we are supposed to find out the value of C air. And what is the relation between them? The relation between C medium and C air is C medium, it is equal to K times C air, right? So we'll rearrange this, and from this we'll get the value of C air. So C air, it is equal to C medium upon K. Right? Now see carefully. Now we know value of C medium. What is value of C medium? It is equal to capital C. We also know value of K. What is the value? It is 3. So this will become capital C upon 3. Right? Now see the options carefully. Which option is matching? Yes. Option C is the correct answer in this situation. So once the oil is removed, the capacity will become C by 3. Right? Now let us move towards second question. It says, if a dielectric slab of thickness 5 millimeter and dielectric constant K equal to 6 is introduced between the plates of parallel plate air capacitor with separation 8 millimeter, then capacitance is option A decreased, option B unaffected, option C almost half, and last option is almost double. Now students, in the previous modules we have already learned that whenever dielectric slab is, whether it is partially filling the capacitor or it is completely filling the capacitor, in either situation capacity of that capacitor will increase, right? So option A, which says decrease, it is an incorrect answer, right? Option B, which says unaffected, again it is incorrect. And option C, almost half, that means it is decreasing, it is again incorrect. So the only correct answer in this particular situation is almost double, which is option D, right? So this was just a concept that we have applied, right? Now let us prove it mathematically. Right, so let us analyze this. So let us start with the solution. So we are provided with a dielectric slab of thickness 5 millimeter and dielectric constant K equal to 6. So therefore I can write T equal to 5 millimeter, K equal to 6. Right, it is introduced between the plates of parallel plate air capacitor with plate separation 8 millimeter. So I can write small d, it is equal to 8 millimeter. So earlier we were having air capacitor. Now in that air capacitor, we are inserting a dielectric slab. So let's say I will start with solution. So first of all, we'll write formula for air capacitor. So for air capacitor, C1, it is equal to epsilon naught A upon D. Now students, we know value of small d. What is the value? It is 8 millimeter. So this will become epsilon naught A upon 8 into 10 raised to power minus 3. Right? Now let us move further. Now students, whenever a dielectric slab which is having dielectric constant K and thickness T is inserted between the plates of air capacitor, then the capacity becomes, let's say C2 is the new capacity, so C2, it is equal to epsilon naught A upon D minus T plus T upon K. Now this formula we have already covered in the previous module. Now students, we know value of T, we also know value of K, we also know value of small d. So let us place these values. So we'll get epsilon naught A upon in bracket 8 minus 5 into 10 raised to power minus 3 multiplied by 5 into 10 raised to power minus 3 upon 6. Right? Now let us carry it further. Now see carefully, 8 minus 5, this will become equal to 3. Right? And 5 by 6 can be written as 0.83. So this will become epsilon naught A upon 3 into 10 raised to power minus 3 plus 0.83 into 10 raised to power minus 3. Right? Now see carefully. Now we'll add these two terms. Right? So if we add these two terms, we'll get C2, it is equal to epsilon naught A upon 3.83 into 10 raised to power minus 3. Now let us carry it further. Now I'll multiply and divide this particular term by 8 into 10 raised to power minus 3. Now see carefully, epsilon naught A upon 8 into 10 raised to power minus 3. Now see the boxed part. Now this value, it is nothing but equal to C1. Right? So I'll replace epsilon naught A upon 8 into 10 raised to power minus 3 by C1. So this will give you C2, it is equal to C1 multiplied by 8 into 10 raised to power minus 3 upon 3.83 into 10 raised to power minus 3. So from here we can cancel out 10 raised to power minus 3, right? And 8 upon 3.83, it is almost 2 times. And therefore I can say my new capacity C2, it is 2 times, or rather nearly 2 times C1. And in this particular situation, I can say capacity is almost doubled. So which is the correct answer? Yes, option D, as we discussed earlier, is the correct answer. So students, in this particular module, we have covered multiple choice questions which are based on the concept of insertion of dielectrics. So students, that's it for this particular module. I'll see you in the next module. Till then, keep learning.